Welcome to Essex County College's Community Education Forum TV series. Now here's your host, Mr. Alfred Bundy.
Welcome to Essex County College's Community Education Forum. I'm your host, Alfred Bundy. I'm the Executive Director for Institutional Advancement here at the college. Before we meet our first special guest today, here's just a brief example of an extraordinary musical talent.
Every time you go away,
I'm gone, yes.
I always say, it's goodbye, dear. Loving you the way I do.
Check it out, right?
He's got a big job tonight, and he's gonna do it to death. Wait.
He grew up in Teaneck, New Jersey, and now resides in West Orange. He has had an award-winning and distinguished career. He has worked with Hall of Fame talents such as Aretha Franklin and Natalie Cole, just to name a few, but he might be best known here as the longtime songwriter, arranger, and musical director for R&B legend Luther Vandross. It is truly my pleasure to welcome to the forum Nat Adderley. Welcome.
Thank you very much, Al.
Well, you know, you're such a renowned musician yourself and arranger, but you come from a legendary musical family. Your roots are with your father, who was a famous jazz trumpeter, Nat Adderley Sr.
Cornetist,
let me get it correct. And of course, your uncle was saxophonist Cannonball Adderley. What was it like growing up with all these musical giants?
When I was young, I hesitate to answer this question because people expect something different. They were not around when I was young. They were on the road all the time. But I was home with Mom.
When did you know you had a gift or you had this talent?
I started taking lessons when I was about nine, I would say. But I started hitting the piano like this, humming and looking at hearing things, pick it out, melodies, when I was more like five.
Now, my father played music and played that, like Louis Armstrong and things like that, so they forced me to play the drum, but I kind of hated the lessons when I first started. I learned to love music later on. Did you enjoy it from the beginning, or was it something that came a little later?
I did. Like I said, when I started taking lessons, of course, with classical, which is European, there was no jazz training. Then certainly nothing else.
You later on, though, in high school, attended a famous school, the LaGuardia High School for Performing Arts, and of course that inspired a TV show and also two movies called Fame. Okay. What was it like going to high school?
Slightly different. When I was there, it was two different schools.
Okay.
We had the same principal. I went to music at home. That was uptown 135th Street. The school that the movie was really based on was performing arts, was downtown. Same principal, we were both LaGuardia. We were LaGuardia High School of Music and Art. They were LaGuardia High School of Performing Arts. Now they're together. We're on Amsterdam Avenue. They merged about 20 years ago, something like that.
You later go on to Yale University, where you graduated, but a degree in African American Studies, where you getting away from the music. Why not music at that time?
In high school, I did a lot of music already. I did a recording.
You wrote for Action Cannonball.
I did a recording with them. Had already joined Valerie Simpson's band. I think it was the summer between my junior and senior year that we went to the Troubadour. My first big professional gig was for Valerie Simpson at the Troubadour in Los Angeles. So I had done all that music already. Somehow I went to college. I thought I wanted to be a lawyer. I just didn't want music anymore. I don't know. I can't remember what it was. But I can tell you that my high school yearbook is full of people writing it again. You write in the yearbooks, they're all right. Okay, Dad, have a good time in college, but let us know when you come back to music, because you are a musician. I don't know what your problem is, all this lawyer talk. This was just like that.
Wow.
Voices We Saw was better known. But we had the Vandross and Robin Clark and Fonzie, but we had some singers that were out of this world. Luther wasn't even the one that I thought was going to be the big star. Really. But, so that's where we met. And we were both writing material.
That's interesting. I was going to ask you, when you think back in the early days, did you see Luther being the superstar that he became?
I wasn't thinking about it with his kids. I wasn't, but I do remember that I just thought Fonzie was going to be a big star. And a couple more ones I can't think of.
Well, you know, it's interesting. You were telling me a story about you guys never performing in Japan. Maybe share that real quickly, why you never went to Japan with Luther, even though he was popular there.
Because he wanted to bring his production. That was his show.
He felt like
the record company should support him in that way and front that so he could take his stuff. I don't know how I was going to get over that. I don't think he'd get on a plane. I think they'd have to ship it. But he wanted to a real tour of that area on a tour bus like we did in the States with all his truckloads of all that stuff we used to carry around. He wanted to do that. They wouldn't do it, and he just never would. We did do Europe a few times. We stayed in London. I mean, we lived in London. My best royalty to this day is my song.
Why you just name a few other songs that you
Wait for Love, although I arranged too many. I can't even think of my favorite arrangements. My favorite arrangement was one of my favorite Lutheran tracks I'm thinking of knocking off my feet and going out of my head.
Which was really a little every classic, but y'all did it all over. Everybody thought it was Luther's song. It was a whole different thing.
And anyone who had a heart just never got off the ground. I love that track cover. Whoever was playing all the sax on it. I love that thing. It's just, when it came out, I was always trying to figure out why that song wasn't playing. One reason is because, you know, Luther put out albums and, like, everything sounded like a hit, so by the time it was on single number two, everybody had already played it. When Luther put a record out, the record companies played everything, so nothing else could be like a sudden big hit and go to the top of the charts. So
we'd be remiss if we didn't mention that you worked with so many other stars, from Natalie Cole to Valerie Simpson, who you mentioned, even the Queen of Soul, Aretha Franklin. Is anybody else that you want to mention that we decided to mention? You know, you've had quite a career.
Oh, I don't know. I think of a track I did with Johnny Gill.
Johnny Gill.
That did pretty much called Just Another Lonely Night. It was on the album with something about the red dress.
Oh, yeah. Put on your red dress.
That was a pretty big selling album.
Wow, that was a great album. And he has such a voice. What a great talent.
Oh, yeah.
You're still performing. And I think people need to know. Now, tell us what you're doing. I just had great fortune to see you at the National ACC. And the jazz trio or quartet, y'all just rocked the house. They go, tell us what you're doing and what we can see you in 2023.
Which is a
classic.
The historical jazz club on 18th Street and all the famous big names in the early part of the century.
Sure.
Played. I love Shanghai jazz. It's here in Madison, New Jersey.
You have the food there. It's just like a Chinese food. I didn't know you had that big fan.
Oh, yes. I do that every 3 months.
Wow.
Also, so I'm around. You have to look.
Can I go to your website or something like that?
Everything I do for myself is on the website. And, you know, I do play for others sometimes, too. Some of them will go on the website. Oh, I wanted to say something because this is Christmas season. And I love this season because Yes. That we did on that record. I did my favorite things and Happy Supplemental Little Christmas.
Oh, I have
so
that.
So they play it in my catalog right now. So I haven't heard it yet, but I'm always have the radio on, waiting for one of those to come. I didn't want to tell you, you mentioned something. This is what I just wanted to say, that while I'm doing jazz now, while I left R&B and pop, when Luther passed away, I was looking around, oh my gosh, I'm not ready to do anything else, I don't know what's going on. And my wife was very successful in the McDonald's business, so I didn't mind just laying back and supporting her. So anyway, but what changed my life drastically was when I got a call from Mary Jane Blige, which is manager, to see if I wanted to come and be her musical director. I really had done Mary before then. I wasn't all into her like that and had her records, but I thought she was great. But when they called, I said, okay, let me see what this is. And I just really just got all her stuff and just listened top to bottom. I fell in love with Mary Jane Blige. I said, I love this woman. I love her writing. I love who she is, what she's about. I just love her. And I can't do this. I mean, she had a young band. It was a hip-hoppy thing. It's just, I mean, after being with Luther and the type of stuff we were doing, I just said, I mean, I can record, but I can't go on the road and lead the band for Mary Jane Blige. As much as I love her, I'm going to be miserable doing this full time, and she goes on the road. We didn't go on the road like that. She was out. So that's when I realized that I didn't want to do that, and I realized that there's no higher in R&B now. I guess I'm ready to change idioms and play jazz for the rest of my life.
And we heard you. Just awesome. Listen, we're out of time. But what advice do you have for young musicians?
Don't do this. love it. You know, don't do this if it's not something you just know that you have to do. It's a spiritual thing. And don't do it because you are looking to be a star. You have to love the process. You have to love this gig and that gig. This low-paying gig, and this one with a band that maybe wouldn't be the one that you would have desired if you were making the calls. You know, but that's just what I'm saying, because it's a hard thing. It's hard to, you know, it's hard to keep going. But what isn't with some other careers would offer. But if you really love it and you have to do it, then you have a happy life doing it.
Let me tell you, speaking of joy, you and your work, not only were you the one something that brought great joy to so many of us, I'm sure as more people even aware of the role you're playing, that you're probably going to find that you probably started a lot of new families. Some of the records, y'all put out some beautiful romantic tunes.
I have heard that very specifically.
Yeah, you talk about the baby's romantic. We really don't even have enough time to cover all this. I'm sure we tell people, check him out on YouTube, check out Nat Adderley Jr. on Wikipedia. He told me they keep changing some of the history, they always have it right. But most of it's there because you've had an amazing journey. I just can't thank you enough for finding time.
Thank you.
Listen, we will be right back. I want to thank Nat again for joining us. But before we go, take a look at Essex County College's Alumni Corner and meet Miss Stephanie Carter, the class of 2002. She's the current vice president of the Essex County College Alumni Association. Check this out.
Whether it's jump-starting a new career or working toward your degree, Essex County College provides access and opportunities to succeed. ECC offers biology, engineering, computer science, nursing and health sciences, criminal justice, business, liberal arts, supply chain management, and social science in-demand programs. Learn more today about Essex County College. Students first.
Welcome back to Essex County College Community Education Forum. I'm your host, Alfred Bundy. It is my distinct honor to introduce our next guest. He began his career at Essex County College as a professor in the business division. He later became the chair of the division and then interim president in July of 2020. He was inaugurated just this past May. Please welcome the ninth president of Essex County College, Dr. Augustine A. Boakye. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Mr. Boakye.
Well, listen, I always have a distinct honor when I can interview my boss. So how you doing, boss?
I am doing good.
You certainly, since the last year when you became the president, what's it been like since this last year or so in this new role? We actually have a hybrid, so you can kind of do what you can do at home, or you can do a combination and come in.
So,
start your educational, higher education career at ECC? Yeah,
Essex is a community school.
Say that part again. So in other words, we have a lot of financial aid.
That is what I'm talking about. That's what I mean. So we have financial aid coming for students. Do you want to know? And recently, that was a contribution by the student to us. That means that the family owns a $80,000 or less in the additional funds.
And we're going to underline that one. If you're out there, $80,000 or less, you can come to Essex County College for free. What's some of the top academic programs offer here?
I would say all of them. Most of them. And that's a very
How about the business side?
Business is
also probably more than ever, people need short programs, maybe just to get back to work or get a certificate. Talk to us about workforce development center programs.
I
want
to see that. Thank you.
appreciate that I can be a physical therapist in my practice. You did something wonderful just this past Thanksgiving. You surprised our student athletes who we house year-round with Thanksgiving dinner. Tell us about the surprise the students had and what that experience was like. That was so wonderful. You know, we don't have a lot of time, but just tell us, reflecting in this past year that you've officially been the president, what's one thing that you thought you knew, but you found out or was a little surprised that it might be a little bit different than what you thought? One thing.
That's what I'm supposed to do. I knew this is coming.
I want to thank you because you're on the way of making some new stories and some new lives of being positively changed because of your dedication and your leadership. So I want to thank you, President, for being with us. Once again, I want to thank our President, Dr. Boakye, for being with us. You have been watching Essex County College's Community Education Forum. For more information on Essex County College, visit our website, essex.edu.
You've been watching Essex County College's Community Education Forum. For more information on Essex County College, visit essex.edu. To catch any of our Community Education Forum shows, check out Facebook or YouTube. We'll see you next time.